worship God this morning. Amen.
Amen.
And the topic of my lesson this morning, we're coming from Galatians 5:22. And the topic of the lesson is the fruit of the Spirit. The fruit of the Spirit. When you find Galatians 5:22 and 23, say amen. Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against there is such no law. That's Galatians 5:22 and 23. The first fruit of the Spirit I want to look at this morning is called love. Love is one of the fruit of the Spirit, and it's called, the definition is affection, reverence for another. We should learn to love and have affection for one another. We should love like Christ loved us. Christ, God, gave his only son for us. Amen?
Amen.
He gave his only begotten son. And the word says, in John 3:16, it says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, and whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
Amen.
I like that kind of love.
I love that.
That's a wonderful kind of love.
Yes, it is.
And we should practice this type of love. As Christians, there is so much hatred going on out there in the world today. We need to reverse that. We need to reverse that and turn it into the God kind of love. Amen?
Right, right.
Amen. Yeah. Let's move along to the next fruit of the Spirit. The next fruit of the Spirit I like to talk about is joy.
Yes.
Joy is a strong feeling of great pleasure and happiness. I'm going to say it again. A strong feeling of great pleasure and happiness. When you have that joy, you have that. That comes from within. That's something that the world can give you. That's something that God gives us. Amen? God gives us that joy. It's that joy, unspeakable joy. And the verse that I came up with is Psalms 66:1. Psalms 66:1 says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands.
All right.
That's the kind of joy that I like to have.
Yes.
And as Christians, we should all be trying to get these fruits of the Spirit.
Yes.
Because this is so awesome. When you get that fruit of the fruit of the Spirit, it just something on the inside of you, it just changes you. It changes the way you feel about yourself and about others as well. And we should practice this every day. We shouldn't do it someday. We should do this every day. Amen.
Amen.
The next one I like to talk about, something that Pastor said on last Sunday, is peace. Peace. A state of physical or mental tranquility, calm. In this world, you know, we need peace. As you look at the news, you see all types of things that are going on in the world, and we need that inner peace. We need that peace to keep us mentally stable. We need that peace. Amen? And the scripture I like to talk about is Psalms 34:14. Psalms 34:14. And it says, depart from evil and do good, seek peace and pursue it, preserve it, go after it. That reminds me of an illustration. It's like when in the old days when people did preserves, figs and stuff, they preserved those figs after they cooked them. They put them in the jar and they let it preserve and they put it up for a later time when they got ready to eat it. But when you have that peace, that stays within inside of you. You should never lose your peace.
Amen.
And you should never let nobody take your peace from you. That's something that God gives us. Amen?
Amen.
All right. The next one, moving right along, the next one I like to talk about is long suffering.
All right.
That's one of my favorites. Long suffering, right. Church. Having or showing patience in spite of trouble, especially caused by people.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's heavy. People in the world, they cause all kinds of trouble for you, especially if they know that you are a Christian. They gonna go out their way to cause all kind of problems for you because they want you to come out the will of God and sin. So that way that can give them something on you.
That's
so they
right.
can talk about you.
That's
and say,
right.
Well, she said she's a Christian.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he said he's a Christian. Don't allow them to do that. Be patient with folks and let them learn to be patient with you. Let us love people, especially because they're not Christians, they're worldly folks.
Mm-hmm.
We know better. So if we know better, we should do better.
Mm-hmm.
And we shouldn't allow them to get us out of the will of God. We got to stay in the will of God at all times because you never know when you may have to reach somebody. Amen?
Right. Yeah,
amen.
Right.
Praise God. And scripture for that is 2 Peter 3:9. 2 Peter 3:9. The Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but is long suffering toward us, not willing that anyone should perish, but all come to repentance. So God doesn't want any of his people to perish. He doesn't want us to die into our sins and go to hell. He wants everyone to be saved. And that's what we should want also. As Christians, we should want to try to get as many people as we can saved for the body of Christ. Amen?
Amen.
All right, moving right along. The next one, so far y'all with me?
Yes.
Okay, the next one is gentleness.
Oh my.
Gentleness means the quality of being kind, tender, a mild manner. And we have to learn to be kind and tender-hearted to one another. Because there are so many people that are mean and full of the devil. And it's heartbreaking. And then you have Christians, so-called Christians, saying, well, I'm a Christian, but look at your actions.
Mm-hmm.
Your actions are going to speak for itself. You can go around all day and say, I'm a Christian, I'm a gentle, kind-hearted person, but once people see you and they hear the words that are coming out your mouth, they gonna speak other words. So let's make sure that we're kind and we're tender and that we're mild-mannered. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
Have that gentle spirit. That gentle spirit. Okay, the verse that I like to talk about on that one is Titus 3:2. Titus 3:2. And it says, to speak no evil of no man, to be raw but gentle, showing all meekness. Speak no evil of no one. Let every word that comes out of your mouth be seasoned, full of grace, seasoned with salt. Because the words that you speak could either hurt somebody or it could either harm somebody. So let us be aware of what we're speaking. Let us speak kind and tender words. Amen?
Amen.
The next one is goodness. I like this one too. Goodness is the state or quality of being good. That's all you got to do. Just be good. Just like I just said a minute ago about gentleness, being good is almost the same. So be good to folks. You want people to be good to you, also be good to them. Okay? You reap what you sow.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? And the definition is Psalms 23 and 6. Psalms 23 and 6. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Say that.
Surely,
say that.
Surely goodness and mercy is going to follow you all the days of your life. All you have to do is do what God say do. Follow in God goodness.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
And when you follow in his goodness, he's going to lead you in the direction that he wants you to be.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Amen.
The next one is faith.
Mm.
Faith, a belief and value or truth or trustworthiness of something or someone. That's what faith is. A belief and value of truth or trustworthiness of something or someone. We put our faith and trust in things. We should be trusting in God.
Amen.
Put your faith and trust in God. We put our faith in our money. We put our faith in our children. We put our faith in our job. We put our faith in our health. We put our faith in all types of things. But when it comes down to God, we don't have our faith in him. And if without God, what would you be? Where would you be without God?
All right.
So we have to remember, this is very important, saints of God, that you keep your faith and trust and belief in God. Don't put you be so quick to trust people, because people will let you down.
Yeah.
But God will never let you down.
All
amen.
Right.
Amen.
Okay, and the Bible verse for that is Romans 10:17. So faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God.
Yes.
Praise God, amen.
Amen.
Praise God. All right. Meekness. This is a very good one. Meekness. Showing patience and gentle disposition. Lacking spirit or backbone, submissive, meekness. We got to have some backbone about ourselves. We got to stand our ground as Christians. We can't allow people to just walk all over us like we some floor mats, because we are not a floor mat. We are Christians, and we have to stand our ground. You got to be patient with folks as well, but you got to have some backbone. Pastor tells us all the time, don't just let people walk all over you. Don't let people do you like that. Because they do it to you one time, 9 times out of 10, they're going to come back and do the same thing to you again.
All right.
So stand your ground. Be gentle, be kind, but stand your ground. And be submissive. That's another word that we don't like to do. We don't like to submit. We look at that as such an ugly word. And it's not. Just submit. Submit to Christ. Submit to your mate. God blesses us with a mate. He blesses us with health and wealth. And we have to learn to be submissive. Amen, Christ?
Amen.
Amen. Okay? The Bible verse for that is James 3:13. Who is a wise man and endure among you. Let him show out of good conversation his works, your meekness of goodness. Amen.
Amen.
Meekness, that's the fruit of the Spirit. We talked about, so far we went over, we have 9 fruits of the Spirit. We talked about joy. We talked about peace.
Mm-hmm.
We talked about long suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness. And last but not least is temperance.
Mm.
Temperance is called moderation or self-restraint, especially eating and drinking. Amen?
Mm.
Okay, temperance. What I got out of this, when a temperance person has to have some type of control.
Mm-hmm.
You got to have self-control in everything that you do.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of time you get off focus when it comes down to being temperance. You don't have no type of control whatsoever. Whatever we're doing, we just fly off the handle mm-hmm. for no reason. We got to learn to control, restrain ourselves. Amen? And when you're eating, drinking, whatever you're doing, make sure you do it in moderation. Don't overdo it. I know sometimes we may go to the store, we see something we like, we'll go buy us a cake or ice cream, whatever your favorite. We sit there, we just eat, 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 eat. Next thing you know, the whole container is gone. You're like, what have I done? It takes moderation.
Yes.
Everything has to be done in moderation.
Yes.
Self-restraint. Learn to control yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Don't fly off the handle. Don't be so easy to get upset about
mm-hmm.
things. Because
yes.
a lot of times we do that too. We get so upset real quick.
Yes.
Our temper, which gets us in trouble. So
yes.
we got to learn to restrain and control ourselves.
Amen.
And the scripture for that is 1 Peter 5:8. 1 Peter 5:8. It says, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, walking about seeking whom he may devour. It's just like when I look at the Animal Kingdom channel. They have the animals, you know, the animals that
mm-hmm.
prey.
Mm-hmm.
They're looking for their prey.
Mm-hmm.
So they waiting for that perfect moment where they can go and attack, and it just sneak up on
mm-hmm.
you, sneak up on you. The next thing you know, they got you.
Mm-hmm.
That's the same way the devil works. So don't allow the devil to do us like that. We're Christians, we're strong. Don't allow the devil to make us do things that we know that's not right. Come out of the will of God. Amen.
Amen.
And now I'm going to close this out with prayer. I want everybody to bow their heads in prayer.
Mm-hmm.
Father God, I want to thank you once again for allowing me to take this time to stand here to give your word to your people, oh Heavenly Father. I pray that something was said, oh Heavenly Father, that could help your people to carry them out through this day. These blessings I pray in Jesus' name. To God be the glory. Amen.
Amen.
Church, say amen.
Amen.